Mickey crossed the threshold and emerged once again into the forest. But it was changed somehow. This wasn't the pastoral wood he remembered. Maybe an apple a day would keep the mushrooms at bay, thought Mickey. Knowing he would need a way to defend himself, Mickey remembered how accurate he always was in the annual apple-throwing contest back home. The signpost was created by Miserabelle, so of course, it had a mischievous streak.
Sure wish that signpost would make up its mind.
Suddenly, Mickey was in another part of the wood. Were these gigantic trees, or had Mickey been shrunk? Mickey found himself back in the clearing and back to his original size. Mickey had to move fast. We'll be right back. Mickey had to move fast.
Uh-oh!
Mickey knew he was closer to Miserabelle now. The very air around him tingled with mischief and danger.
Thank you.
Mizrabel taunted Mickey with her cruel laugh. But perhaps she was secretly worried about how close he was getting. With the frights and sprites of the forest behind him, Mickey faced the next part of his quest. Ah, the grumpy old oak tree. Like all of Mizrabel's illusions, he was no friend to Mickey. Rainbow Gem was finally his. Now it was time for our hero to move on. Exploring the castle halls, Mickey now had one of the Rainbow Gems that would help him save Minnie. But he knew there were more to find, and the Masters of Illusion would not give them up without a fight. The Rainbow Bridge to Minnie would only appear when all 7 Rainbow Gems were collected. There was still work to be done. Mickey emerged into a toy box of peril, another of the witch's illusions.
Thank you.
Mickey had to move quickly and carefully, for the cards weren't playing fairly. Mickey had gotten so close. He was certain he'd do better next time.
Thank you.